This is Sam from Uniondale, and you are tuning in to another edition of the Sam I Analyze Show. Folks, a boxing legend returns to the ring. Let's analyze. Manny Pacquiao has still got the itch. He still wants to get in the ring. At 45 years young, he feels he still got it. I thought he walked away in 2021 after he lost to, what was it, Ugas? He lost to him back in 2021. Manny said, all right, I'm out. No, this time is I'm out. And you heard the rumbles yesterday. Well, it's official. Manny Pacquiao to face against Chihiro Suzuki in Japan. Pretty quickly, mind you. It's happening July 28th. And did I say Manny Pacquiao at 45 years young? He's going to be facing Suzuki, who just turned 25. But hey, this is not going to be the traditional boxing rules. Manny Pacquiao said, yeah, I want to fight, but, and this is going to be too quick. Like, you know, this is, we announced it today and it basically happens in a half hour. So, hey, here's the stipulation. 3 rounds, 3 minutes at 150 pounds. Hey, Manny Pacquiao said, hey, listen, I'm older. I can't do, and oddly enough, Pacquiao's trying to get back. He was supposed to be at this, you know, before he lost to Ugas. He was supposed to be getting ready to fight. That was a tune-up to a possible Errol Spence fight. So, I mean, I don't know. Is that what he's looking at? I don't know. But Manny Pacquiao is back. You know how I feel. You know, the guy is about is 20 years younger. I mean, Suzuki is 20 years younger than Pacquiao. Pacquiao is still got, I told you in that last video, in that Mike Tyson video I did a few videos ago. The range of motion, the bobbing and weaving and all of that may go, but he still has the ability. He can still catch him. And Suzuki is more of his expertise is more in MMA anyway. But, so I expect Manny Pacquiao to dominate and handle his business, especially according to these rules. But it's going to be interesting. It's going to be interesting. A lot of older fighters have done these exhibitions, and Manny Pacquiao wants to do this, for charity. You see a few people have done things like this, It's going to be interesting. You know, Ricky Hatton has had these quote unquote charity fights and for causes. And I mean, is Floyd going to come back? I mean, this is what these guys are doing. But hey, look, if these are the stipulations, I think Manny Pacquiao is going to be all right. I think he's going to be all right. But he's fighting in a few weeks. Very shortly, folks, very shortly. But we will see what happens. I want to see what this leads to. I'm not too interested in this fight, but it, I mean, is a 45, 46 year old Manny Pacquiao, is he trying to go fight a Errol Spence or what have you? So we're going to see what happens with that. Now, folks, Caitlin Clark continues to be in the news. USA basketball dropped the ball. WNBA, y'all continue to drop the ball. Instead of Caitlin Clark catching this, instead of her catching the applause and the kudos, weren't you guys flying coach, commercial, whatever it is? Wasn't that an issue for y'all? and all of this and all. And then you guys got someone here to put the eyeballs in the seats. Did y'all hear? I mean, yesterday alone, Caitlin Clark. Let me analyze this real quick. Caitlin, the WNBA is used to about $4,000 to just under $7,000, 7,000 viewers, an event, okay? And people got really, really in their feelings. Who is this girl? How dare she? We've been doing this longer than her, and she's getting all the pub? Yeah, she is. And y'all need to be thankful. Y'all need to be grateful. As Caitlin Clark and they just continue to beat her up. You're watching people beat her up and do all this stuff and be ungrateful. Yesterday, folks, yesterday, you're hearing this? Yesterday, and this was the actual footage, against the Washington Mystics, the Fever game, who normally play in an arena that sat 4,200 people, was moved, you ready for this, to an arena that sat 20,000 people. They needed 16,000 more seats. And the tickets sold out in 30 minutes. Rebecca Lobo and weighed in on the, you know, on the comments and the USA. Look, listen, they said that it's the inexperience. The WNBA better come out with a statement. USA Basketball, go back to the drawing board. Go back to the drawing board. You know, like in school, you see this? Do it again. We don't want to hear that. The woman is putting fans in the seats. Can't say that, USA Basketball. WNBA, you guys are bullying the golden child? Wrong. You guys are wrong with this. And Caitlin Clark, kudos to you. Kudos to you. Those ladies don't understand what they have. You know, they don't, they want to get more money, but they don't realize that you have to put the fans in the seats in order to say, oh, we're not getting paid like the men. Yeah, the men fill up the arenas. Okay? They fill up the arenas. They sell out the arenas. In order for you to get the money you want, you gotta treat Caitlin a little better. Cause she's getting the fans in the seats, y'all. Come on, ladies. Now we stick with basketball as we get ready to get to the end here. LeBron James and the Lakers are still looking for a coach. Still looking for a coach. And I told you on Monday's video, I didn't think that Danny Hurley was going to take that proposition. You know, LeBron James is going to be 40 in December. And the turnstile, which is the Los Angeles Lakers of coaching, have had 7 coaches since Phil Jackson. What was it back in, when was Phil last there, 2011? Phil Jackson. They have a carousel of coaches. And the question I have here, is LeBron James more of a help, a hindrance, or a help? I mean, Darvin Ham. Coaches have seen LeBron James be disrespectful. Frank Vogel, who won a championship. I think LeBron James is just too much of a headache, man. Even at 39 years young, about to be 40. I think LeBron James is just too entitled. And I get it. He has all the accolades, but he's not going to allow a guy to coach him. And I think that had a lot to do with it. I think the Lakers are in a real bind here. And I don't know who they're going to get. I mean, I think they're going to need someone like a Mark Jackson or Jeff Van Gundy. I think that's what they're going to do. I don't think a JJ Redick should be in the fold anymore. JJ Redick, if you're going to be a coach, a first-time coach, do you really want that kind of stress and that kind of pressure? A guy who's really going to do his own thing? And LeBron James, and I get it. You've got your own podcast with LeBron, so it's going to work out. Yeah, I don't know about that. I don't know about that, but I definitely think the LeBron thing has something to do with it. And that's why people are like, I don't know about that. What the Lakers really need to do is really start looking at what does Anthony Davis want? That's what you really want. Because I think LeBron is good for another year, maybe two, but he's out of here. Now it's that time. Aaron Rodgers is absent from the two-day mandatory minicamp. Uh-oh. No, not to worry. The quote of the day goes to Coach Robert Saleh, who said, "Aaron and I spoke before OTA started. He's very good in communication. He's been here the entire time. It's unexcused, but he had an event that was very important to him, which he communicated." I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in. Folks, I'm on Facebook, at SamIAnalyze. On Instagram, at SamIAnalyze. On the platform, now known as, formerly known as Le Twitter, at SamIAnalyze. Please like, share, subscribe, and you see that notification bell to the right. Please click on that. That will let you know the next time I drop another video. Thanks for tuning in. And as always, a tout à l'heure.